At the outset. Let me say that not one bit of domestic violence is tolerable. O.J. Simpson is not proud of some of the things that happened during his marriage. Does that add up to murder? No. Mr. Darden talked about 1985, but he missed the whole point. Something interesting happened in 1985. Mark Furman responded to a call on Rockingham. He saw a white woman married to a powerful black man. He didn't like that. He didn't like that because he's a hardened racist. Mark Furman is the one who said, if I see an interracial couple, I'm going to stop them. If I don't have a reason, I'm going to make something up. So you have a lying Mark Furman, the personification of evil, who found the gloves. But don't be fooled. This isn't just one officer. Mark Furman represents the entire LAPD. Now, you may not know this, but you are empowered. Your decision has a major implication both in this courtroom and outside of it. Things happen for a reason in life. Maybe that's why we're gathered together. Something in your background, your character, helps you to know that this is wrong. Maybe you're the right people at the right time to be able to say, no more. We can't have this. What they have done is disgraceful. O.J. Simpson is entitled to an acquittal. They have entrusted this case to a man who says he'd like to see all niggers gathered together and killed. That is genocide. That man speaks like Adolf Hitler. Now, since you can't trust the man and you don't trust the people, is it any wonder, in the defining moment in this trial, when they asked O.J. Simpson to try on the glove, and the glove didn't fit. It didn't fit because it wasn't his. If you don't stop this cover-up, who will? Send them a message. Let them know that your verdict will travel far outside these walls. Ladies and gentlemen, remember these words. If it doesn't fit, you must acquit. If it doesn't fit, you must acquit. If it doesn't fit, you must acquit.